What is up? This is Arlington and I just landed right now. I just bought my dream car. No, I'm kidding. But if y'all paid attention to my past video, or Tesla too, but if y'all paid attention to my past videos, an Audi R8 is one of my dream cars. But that's not what we're gonna be talking about today. Today we're gonna be discussing something that I've waited 3 months to make this video because I wanted to make sure that I was gonna provide value into my video and not just throwing out facts or just throwing out, you know, suggestions. So with that being said, let's proceed with the video on how I ended a German Roach infestation at a commercial building. So if you're new to the channel, subscribe, and if you're not new to the channel, welcome back. And there's two things I want to clarify before I proceed with this video. Is one, if you see any YouTube videos with no thumbnail, it means that that video is for my customers. I want to have some videos from in my website, so just a little bit to be more interactive in my website. It's up to you if you want to watch them, but just wanted to give you a heads up. That's one. Second thing is most of my videos are just like how I do it. I don't want you guys to feel forced to letting you guys know on how you should do it. You know, I don't want to be like other YouTubers telling you, hey, how you should do this. I'm telling you how I did it, okay? So I just want to clarify that just in case you don't want to, you feel pressured or forced to like do things certain way just because I do it, just because like Flowzone called me a pest control influencer. Like, that doesn't mean you should do it too, okay? I just wanted to clarify those two things. Before I proceed, so how I ended the German roach infestation. This is a commercial kitchen. I haven't done it. I've done it on a residential home just once. I'm just waiting on the results. I did it 2 weeks ago, but I'm pretty sure it's gonna be a good, great outcome. And the reason why I think it's gonna be a great outcome is because 3 months ago, I fumigated a commercial kitchen. The reason I fumigated, I fogged it instead of just spraying, baiting, dusting, is because I did it 2 to 3 times and it wasn't working. They will see results, but not a huge difference. So what I did is I'm like, you know what? I'm gonna go for the fogging. And the reason why I was hesitant about the fogging is because one pest control owner told me that fogging makes it worse, right? But there's this other guy, they have like over 700 five-star reviews that told me that they use fogging when it comes to infestations. So I didn't know who to listen to, so I was like, you know what, let me try it myself. So 3 months ago, and I'll even put the video on the screen, that it happened on the October 5th is when I did this procedure. I wanted to wait 3 months before I gave the results. I would have let you guys know I wanted to wait 3 months just in case if it wasn't a good procedure or if it was a bad procedure. I mean, if it was a good procedure or it wasn't a bad procedure. I mean, it was a bad procedure. But 3 months forward, today's the 2nd of January. I'm gonna be uploading this actually tonight, and I wanted to share my results, and it actually came out good. I was checking the traps. The traps only have 6 German roaches. Within the past 3 months, I've only found a total of six German roaches on all the glue traps I placed after the fog. What does that mean? I believe the infestation ended. Not because of this chemical right here that I got put on by someone else, and it's called Pyrocide 300. Not Pyrocide 100, not Pyrocide 200, because those are available, but my friend that works in the pest control industry told me that 300 is the way to go if you want to end an infestation. So when you do this, make sure I do it differently. Every pest control owner does it differently, right? That everybody I notice when it comes to German roaches, everybody has a different tactic. Everybody, when it comes to especially residential homes, I've noticed some people use termite foam right behind the fridge, you know, or they use nothing but dust. Some just do nothing but spraying and baiting. I do a little bit of everything, and that's going to be a whole different video for residential homes. But today I want to focus on commercial properties. And then if you ever get a call for an infestation on a commercial kitchen, I recommend this route. Like I mentioned before, I recommend it. Doesn't mean you need to feel pressured to do it. If you have your own different tactic or you want to try a different route, then by all means. But with that being said, I use a DSV fogger. you can find on Amazon or any pretty much any pest control store. I was looking for this other machine. I can't think of the name right now, but I'll put it on the screen that they use, the other company that my friend uses when it comes to German roach infestations. But that one's $1,000. So I was like, you know what, let me go a little bit more affordable, which is like a $300 device instead of a $1,000 device, right? And I wanted to do a trial and error. I'm like, if it doesn't work, then oh well, I'll buy the $1,000 machine. I can't think of the name, but it ended up working. So what I did is I'll put it on the screen. Like I said, is I start from one corner of the kitchen and I just work my way up all the way to the front of the exit doors or wherever you want to name it. And I just pretty much start from the top and then work my way down. And then I make sure I fog. The most important part for me is fogging right behind the fridge or fogging right behind the freezer, because we all know that that's where they accumulate. So I did that. You notice in the video, I do that. And that's pretty much it. Like, and then 3 months later, I noticed that they only had 6 German roaches. But of course, I have them on a monthly plan where I come on a monthly basis. I convinced them, because they were on the quarterly plan with 2 other pest control businesses, but they couldn't end the infestation. All they did was spraying, baiting, dusting, and they couldn't end it, right? So that's why I was like, you know what? I need to go for the fogging round, because it was just bad. The infestation was crazy. Like, I put 2 giant glue traps and they were just filled with German roaches. So that's why I decided to just, you know, fog the place, you know, give it a try. I wanted to see if it actually works, and it did. I have this account. I convinced this account that they need to go on a monthly plan. I told them, hey, this is an infestation. It can't be on a quarterly plan. And it's a commercial account, so I don't know why they put the other 2 companies. One of them is a big franchise company, right? And then the second one is a small local company. And I was surprised that both of them put them on a quarterly plan instead of a monthly plan. And I convinced the owner or the rep, and they're like, yeah, that's fine. Like, just end this infestation. And now I got them on a monthly plan. And now what I do, ever since I fogged the place, I go out there and put a growth regulator, either with the little device, which I'll portray on the screen, or just mixing my pump sprayer with the growth regulator, which is Gentrol. You can use Teco Pro. As of now, I have Gentrol because that's what I have in stock, but I might transition to Teco Pro. I mean, I do have Teco Pro for fleas, but I'm just trying to get rid of Gentrol. But anyways, that's what I do now on a monthly basis, because, you know, like I said, that I only found 6 German roaches within the 3-month span. So there's still a few roaches every now and then, but 6, right, with the total of like probably 1,000 German roaches, because this infestation was crazy. So now I just put them on a monthly plan. I go out there and spray with Gentrol, a growth regulator, so I can prevent them from reproducing. And that's the most important part, it's just preventing them from reproducing again. And now I won me a lifetime customer, because I ended their infestation, and 2, now I got a monthly plan, which is consistent. It's gonna be easy. I just go out there and gotta spray real quick. Boom, get my little paycheck and start growing my business. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Give it a thumbs up if you actually acknowledge anything. Also, I forgot to mention this in the video. Make sure you're using a good mask. I used to have this other mask. It will break easily as soon as I would tighten it up. So I went a little bit more expensive route, because sometimes going with the cheapest route could lead to being more expensive. So make sure you go with this brand and you'll be set. So if you found this video knowledgeable, or you learned something new, hope you give it a thumbs up. But like I said, everybody has a different route or tactic when it comes to German roaches, but this is my tactic when it comes to attacking commercial kitchen accounts.